Hello, Lou Engel. Yesterday we laid out the prophetic vision for the 21-day fast, the 1st through the 21st, beginning this evening. We believe that we could be in an amazing shifting moment, even yet, for the elections, for the President Trump, particularly facing something in Georgia, and also for the Senate seats in Georgia that will actually restrain, if those Republican senators are elected, it will restrain the Democratic attempt to stack the courts so that they could actually stand against a court case that could reverse Roe v. Wade. I'm an intercessor for the unborn. I'm unashamedly an abolitionist. Something has happened in my heart. This nation cannot go on with child sacrifice. And I say that term because abortion has ceased to subpoena the conscience of America. It is not abortion, it is child sacrifice. And those listening, if you've had abortions, we just thank God for His mercy and for His forgiveness. The blood of Jesus covers us from all sin. But let's call it what it is. It is fueling the witchcraft, the demonization, and the destruction of this nation. The altar of Baal must be torn down. And I believe it's come down to Georgia. My friend Dean Briggs recently had this dream. President Trump had called for a variety of people to attend a series of invitation-only, closed-door sessions at a nice hotel. I was invited, but I did not understand what he truly wanted or the gravity of the situation in his mind. I was aware of a handful of meetings, but slowly realized that there were many more sessions that I first anticipated. This was a big deal. Also, what seemed to be rather generic state-related meetings were actually a series of groomings, interventions, and coming-of-age sessions for President Trump's son. Surprisingly, I was key part in these sessions, but I found myself largely uninterested. I believe this is a prophetic word for intercessors, for people, Christians in America, who maybe lost heart, that have ceased fighting and have felt like, well, whatever will be, will be. But I believe God, even in this dream, is saying, you don't miss this moment. He says, I was a key part of these sessions, but I found myself largely uninterested. President Trump tried to get my attention and express his frustration at least 2 to 3 times over the course of the dream, leaving other meetings to search for me and find me and urge me to participate. Wow. I believe the President Trump is actually God in this situation, is searching and looking and pursuing people to participate in the urgency of intercession. I was quite uninterested, so at one point I found myself in a big kitchen passing time on my iPad. The kitchen was busy, but there was something like a parade drum line in the kitchen with a big bass drum right beside me pounding hard. The guy wouldn't stop. It was distracting and annoying, but felt important. Yet I persisted in my boredom to avoid the meetings anyway. Suddenly, President Trump finds me there and quite frustrated, urges me to finally join. At this point, I know I've missed so much, it will be very hard for me to get caught up and have anything meaningful to contribute. But he insists. I could tell from his expression that he deeply believes that my part matters. He says with great meaning, it's for my son, Moab, M-O-A-B, in big letters, adding extra emphasis to his son's name, as if this should give me a clue about how important this was, almost like this was a child that nobody previously knew was his, an illegitimate or embarrassing child that he needed help with, but still cared about greatly. I finally go into a large conference hall. There are many large circular tables with 10 to 15 people each. Everyone is eating. I'm sure my place at my table is lost. I feel very out of place and embarrassed at my tardiness, hesitant to join. Only then do I realize that I have been positioned right by Moab, whom I never see, but I know they have been waiting for me. They wanted me to pay attention to him or help him shape him at this critical time. Well, here's what's stunning about this dream. I believe that Moab has a very prophetic meeting right now. Something about the rulership of President Trump. Something about the son that is being given dominion. God says in the book of Daniel chapter 7, and then I saw one like the Son of Man, and to him has been given dominion. Well, I believe possibly our last opportunity for breakthrough in this nation, even for this election, actually comes down to the state of Georgia, which is absolutely stunning to me, because today we receive this. Actually, it was on Thanksgiving, that Sidney Powell, the woman that's been doing the research into these Dominion voting machines that it looks like it's filled with fraud and deception, she says this. She says, Georgia is slammed by Powell's 104-page lawsuit. Exposed. The hands behind Dominion. On Thanksgiving Day, Sidney Powell filed a lawsuit in Georgia, which was referred to by as her Kraken released. I would like to share with you some insights of this indictment, and it is being dubbed Moab, the mother of all bombs. Could God be saying to us that we are, even if we've been out of the picture in intercession, God has said, I need you right now to stand next to the Son, next to His dominion machines, to these dominion machines, to take dominion, and that we were to loose a bomb, a Moab bomb, the mother of all bombs, in this fast, to break through in Georgia for the two senators and for the elections, that God would use this dominion exposure to break through into all the states that use these machines. This to me is stunning, that today, even as I'm starting, we're starting this evening on this 21-day fast, that this dream of this man, that he needed, Trump needed us to stand with his son Moab, the mother of all bombs. I think it means I need you right now in a 21-day Daniel fast to break through the demonic powers that seek to destroy the future of this nation and the calling for the courts and the unborn. So for 21 days, right now, we begin to pray, Lord, we pray that God, you would drop the mother of all bombs, Moab, that you would break the dominion of darkness, that you would expose these dominion machines, that God, you would expose fraud, you would expose, God, wickedness in high places, that you would loose this bomb for the sake of President Trump and for his right, even yet for the last thing in Georgia. We pray for a massive movement in Georgia for people to understand this is like the future for a nation, the future for the life of the unborn. We pray for the African American churches to realize that they could rise as an abolition movement for the ending of abortion in America. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would stir men and women to vote for life in Jesus' name. Lord, this election is not about Trump. It is literally about this nation removing this covenant with death, that God says, if you don't remove it, I will remove it. I will sweep away your covenant with death with a terror. In Jesus' name, we cry out for mercy. We pray for these two senators, Republican senators, Perdue and the other gal. We pray in the name of Jesus that, grant you would loose favor on them, that in this 21 days, you would shift the tide of public opinion in the election. And God, you would turn the tide of history and hold the Senate. Lord, raise up, God, the Ecclesia Senate over the Senate right now. In Jesus' Jesus' name, I pray and I call forth every man and woman listening. Stir it, God, 21 days for the bomb, for the Moab bomb, the mother of all bombs, to expose dominion in Jesus' name. Amen.